way shit just so bad.
Working a straight shift and I ain't made shit. I wish I could
buy me a spaceship and fly.
Ooh, not a dead cat, baby. Say it. Say it, I dare you. Tell me it's a dead cat. Oh, ka-chinga. Let's go.
I could buy me a spaceship and fly past the sky.
What's good, YouTube? It's your man, TK the Official, and I'm back. Man, we are back. AMC, baby. We are back, and we are live, and I can't wait to get into the show. Let's roll it. You guys know I like to have fun in my intros. Shout out to my man Trey Trace, who does a great analysis, especially going over the charts, okay? Shout out to him. If you guys want to get a really in-depth analysis on the chart on AMC or any other stock, please make sure you check out Trey Trace's YouTube page. He does an absolute wonderful job. As always, guys, thank you to all of my subscribers, all of my old subscribers, and all of my new subscribers, and anyone thinking of subscribing to this channel right now. I appreciate all the love that you've been giving me. We are on a goal and a mission to get to 500 subscribers. I have a lot of stories that I would like to share with you all, and we are on a goal and a mission after that to make it to 1,000. All right, 4 weeks. You know the stories. You know what we heard. AMC was a dead cat. AMC was not going to squeeze. AMC was just a meme, a stock. Something that Wall Street Bets was just pushing online and something that wasn't going to happen. We heard what happened with GameStop. We heard everyone saying that this wasn't going to happen. Well, guys, let me tell you, it's happening. Now, I'm no Trey Trades, but this just looks like a stairway to heaven. And from what I can tell, this is a pattern that seems to be developing over the last 3 days.
All right, guys, we know what's going on with AMC, okay? We know all about the short interest. This is from my guy, Lior, here, okay? Great follow. Follow him on Twitter, okay? IORS3, okay? Listen, we know about the short interest on 361 million, 55.13 million shares shorted, okay? We know all about the 7.9 million shares. We know that it's $52 million, okay, with 16.7 interest. We know that they're down over 280 million on the year alone, okay? These guys are hurting. These guys are bleeding, okay? And they're trying to stop the damage as best as they can, okay? At some point in time, they're going to know that they're going to have to hit the eject button, all right, and go ahead and try to jump out here and get on top of this, guys. It's really important that you do not sell your shares, okay? They are going to try to continue to short the stock, except this time they're going to short it at a higher price, okay? Because they're going to think that as soon as they shoot the price up to $80, okay, or to $50, that we are going to start selling our shares, all right? The only way that we're going to get up to the levels that GameStop got to and past that, guys, is if we continue to hold, okay? And not only if we hold, if we continue to buy and hold, okay? Buy and hold. Now, again, from my buddy Trey Trades at Trey Trades, AMC will have about 120,000 option calls expiring in the money on Friday. If this closes over 8, it could cause a gamma squeeze. Now, keep that in mind, guys. Where we close that today, we are already over that. All right, guys, so let's take a look. Of those 120 options that are going to be expiring on Friday, I have 2 of them. Okay. I also have 2 other options that are going to expire in June and also going to expire in January. Sometimes with these things, with these hedge funds, you never know when these things are going to happen. It's all a game. It's all a psychological game. All right. So if and when they wanted to hold out a little bit, I was willing to hold out with them. Okay. And as you can see at the top, I got 779 shares. I had been thinking about adding my shares, guys, and I had been adding to them. I originally brought in around $11, and I have been adding in, and I got my cost basis down to $8.79, okay? And so now I'm in the money. But if I would have stayed at 11 and I didn't try to add to my trade average and didn't try to average down, as they say, I would have still been in the hole, okay? So those are the advantages, okay? If you buy and hold and you're holding and it's down, just keep chipping away at it. Just keep chipping away, okay? Stocks do come back up. Okay, guys, again, I am not a financial advisor, but if you're looking for a short to long-term play, okay, and a stock that can bring you a big return in a short amount of time, at this particular point in time,
AMC is probably the best stock to play, okay? There's tons of money coming back into the stock. There's a lot of good catalysts coming forward. The movie theaters are opening back up. The pandemic is starting to come to a close. Vaccines are starting to be passed out and spread around, and businesses look like they're coming back to life, okay? AMC is a great, great, great play, and it looks like there's going to be a big squeeze soon. I remember a couple weeks ago when it was around $7, and then one day I woke up one Friday morning, and the stock was sitting there at $20, and I called my cousin. I said, yo, you got to sell. This time, do not sell, okay? AMC to the moon, AMC to $1,000, okay? Do not sell, okay? Buy, 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 but I'm not telling you to buy because I am not a financial advisor. That's all I have for you today. Please make sure that you subscribe to the channel, okay? Please make sure that you like the video, and please make sure that you share. You guys be safe, make wise decisions, and I'll holler at you next time. I've been working this gray shift, and I ain't made shit. I wish I could buy me a spaceship and fly past the sky.